ओम श्री गणेशाय नमः। ओम श्री सरस्वत्यै नमः। ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। ओम समस्त जनकल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरं। ओम सच्चिदानंदरूपाय विश्वोत्पत्यादिहेतवे तापत्रय विनाशाय श्रीकृष्णाय वयं नमः। हरि ओम। इन द सूत्र नंबर 54 नारद जी सेड दिस अनिर्वचनीय प्रेम इज गुणरहितम कामनारहितम प्रतिक्षण वर्धमानम अविच्छिन्नम सूक्ष्मतरम अनुभव रूपम। इट इज फ्री फ्रॉम ऑल क्वालिफिकेशंस एंड एट्रीब्यूट्स, फ्री फ्रॉम ऑल डिजायर्स, एवरी मोमेंट ग्रोइंग, अनब्रोकन, अखंड, एक्सट्रीमली सटल एंड ओनली एंड यू हैव टू एक्सपीरियंस इट, अनुभव रूपम। एंड व्हेन वन गेट्स दिस टाइप ऑफ prema, then what happens to that devotee? That is said here in the next sutra 55. Tat prapya tadeva avalokayati.
Tat prapya tadeva avalokayati.
Tadeva shrunoti.
Tadeva shrunoti.
Tadeva bhashayati.
Tadeva bhashayati.
Tadeva chintayati.
Tadeva chintayati.
Tat prapya means having gained, having experienced, realized this anirvachaniya parama amrita swarupa prem, tadeva avalokayati. He sees that love alone everywhere. That Bhagwan who is prema swarupa, whether you say he sees prema swarupa Bhagwan everywhere, or he see his love only manifesting everywhere. And other than that love, he can't just see anything else. And tadeva shrunoti. Whatever he hears Bhagwan's love only everywhere. Tadeva bhashayati. That alone he speaks. And he wants other people also to speak that only. Bhashayati. And tadeva chintayati. And that only he thinks. Now you see here, seeing, hearing, these are the function of the sense organs. Bhashanam is of the speech. Chintanam is of mind. These are the upadhi, isn't it, we have got? Jnanendriyas, karmendriya, that speech. And also mind, antakkaranam. Means what? All personality levels and layers are filled with that love only. So if he is thinking, only he think of that love only. Tadeva, tadeva. Now you see here, even in our worldly life, any person who attains something which is very, very dear to that person, isn't it true that that person only sees that and wants to see that only? And he wants to speak only about that. And he wants people also to speak only about that. Huh? And only constant thought is there. Even all other activities are centered only at that. And the best example is a little baby that is born in the family. I tell you, that baby doesn't do anything but keeps the whole household busy 24 hours. Happily busy. Constantly. What a bachchu is doing now? And what bachchi is doing now? You are sleeping and that mother is working in the kitchen. Again she will come and see you. There is no other thing. Tadeva. And all the child, whatever is it, whether crying or any chattering, or any kind of sound that child makes that delights. And baby is speaking. What baby is speaking? Once, you know, I went to some house and that baby was chatting, but and I didn't pay attention. The mother was very angry with me. You are not listening to baby. I said, what the baby is saying? We're so clearly saying. What it saying that the baby wants a toy from you, you are not giving toy. But when did she say that baby saying? You didn't understand. You sannyasis are useless. Shrunoti. What is the problem? There is some problem. Tadeva shrunoti. And tadeva bhashayati. And speaks only that, no other topic. And it is true that they want other people also to speak only about it. This child is so sweetie, cutie, cutie baby, you know. Love. And all chintanam, all planning, everything is centered on that or not. No other. Achcha. One man got diamond ring. That was very, very special kind of thing with a great possession. And he wanted, you know, that people should keep on asking, what is the diamond? It's so such a beautiful, where did you get that? Nobody was asking anything. And he was getting frustrated also, you know. Constantly trying to show or say something. He got so frustrated, he set his house on fire. What? Fire? And standing there, people gathered. There also he was doing. And suddenly some ray of light fell on that diamond and shining. And one man asked him, hey, what a beautiful diamond ring. Where did you get it from? He said, if you had asked this earlier, my house would have been saved. Why you didn't ask? Somebody with Olympic gold medal and all that. Huh? Anyway, enough of the example. Now see, when these things we get, our mind is completely in that. I want to see that only. And in the newspaper or magazine, our report has come. We want to see that only and keep paper cutting many copies and go on sending to everybody whether they like it or not. Report dekha. But this bhakta is very well. He doesn't do anything of this kind of thing, you know, paper cutting and all that. But tat prapya. See, idea is, his whole being is filled with that love. Now I want to tell you, serious point. Every time I tell you serious only, tat prapya tadya alokati means what? If the sun rises and the lotus opens up, in that also he sees the love of God only. And if he sees even how the cow is licking the calf, cleaning, or how that calf is suckling and then drinking milk from the udder, at the same time the cow, you know, one cleaning. In that also he sees Bhagwan's love only. And even one mother is fondling that child, playing with a child, in that also he sees Bhagwan's love only. Srishtir Madhura. We may say the mother and child and love, but he sees only Bhagwat love. How Bhagwan's love is expressing through all the botanical life and all the jivas, I had gone on safari once, and one drishya always keeps coming in my mind. In that, you sit in the jeep, and then all the animals are freely open. There, suddenly there was utter silence. And the guide told, "You watch now." Mother Chitta, she spotted some deer somewhere. And the little cup also was there with little baby. And the way she dashed, that was a sight to see. But see, that deer was swift. And the cheetahs and all that, if they one sweep, if they can catch it, they can catch. But other than they don't have too much of stamina to run. A deer runs. The cheetah could not get. And was gone so fast somewhere. And that little one, looking for mother. And we were worried whether that will be, we will find that. The guide said, "You don't worry. Oh, sab pata kar lenge. Because they smell, that sense very strong and all that. And one place, that mother Chita was panting. And this little one went there. Little one went to that mother and started caressing, kissing, as though saying, doesn't matter, it's all right. But a mother was so exhausted, tired. And after a few minutes, suddenly she also regained her breath. And the way she held that little child of her that come and started kissing, loving. What a sight. What love was that? From where that love comes? It is divine. Wild animal, but their love is mild. You see anywhere how that love? Tadeva avalokayati. What that person see? The beauty of this srishti, the glory of this srishti. That love is only expressing somewhere the upadhis are tamasic, some are rajasic, some sattvic, some vishuddha sattva and all that. But it is love only, no? See, man loves his body. How much he loves body? How? It is love for atma only which he does not know. Tat prapya. Tadeva avalokayati, tadeva shrunoti, tadeva bhashayati. And the birds are chirping in their song also, he can listen to that Bhagavan singing. Tadeva chintayati. All the senses, speech, mind, everything is in that. Prema swarupa he has become. And he sees that prema alone. That prema alone. Now, we have seen right from the beginning of the prema of the highest quality. Param prema rupa, amrita swarupa, nishkama rupa. And keval avichinna anuraga rupa and all that bhakti you have seen. Now Naraji takes up the topic of secondary form of devotion. Everyone cannot have that type of devotion, right? Therefore he says, now the parama prema we have seen, but now the other prema also we can see, and which Bhagwan accepts. Bhagwan has no problem. Now what is that? Now see the Sutra 56. Gauni Tridha, Guna Bhedat, Artadi Bhedat Va, Gauni Tridha, Gauni Bhakti, feminine gender, therefore say Gauni Tridha of three kinds. Gauni, one meaning is secondary kind of thing, and Gauni means Guna Yukta. Like in Vishnu Sahasrara, they say, Yani Namani Gaunani Vikyatani Mahatmanaha. There Gaunani, Bhagwan's name, no name can be secondary importance. All Guna Yukta, they are names. Now here, this also, this bhakti is Guna Yukta. What are the gunas? Sattva Gun, Rajo Gun, Tamo Gun. So Sattvik Bhakti, Rajasik Bhakti, Tamasik Bhakti. Is love only in expressing in this way? Why three kind of these Gauni Bhakti is there? He said because Guna Bhedat, because of the division of Gunas, of Prakriti Gunas, Sattvaya Tamas, or Artadi Bhedatva, or because of the devotees of different nature. Artadi Bhed. Now this directly refers to Bhagavad Gita. Because he has not described all of them. Artavadi Ved only said. In the Bhagavad Gita 7th chapter, Bhagavan said, Chaturvidha bhajante maham jana sukratin arjuna arto jidnyasur arthardhi jnani cha bharashtar shabha. Now, Jnani Bhakta already talked about, Parama Prema, he is a Jnani Bhakta. Yad Jnatva, Yad Prapya, Oto alag ho gaya. The other three, Artha Jidnyasu Artharthi. Artha means the one who is in distress, difficulty, sankatas, dukkham. Artha Bhakta. Second is, Arto Jidnyasu. Jidnyasu means who wants to know Bhagwan, or wants to know about bhakti, wants to know the truth, but he does not know that now. And Artharthi. Artha, Arthi. Arthi means he is desirous of Artha, prosperity. Three bhaktas are there, three kinds. Chaturit, fourth is separated. Bhagavan says, Jnani to Atma eva me matam. Jnani is my Atma only. About that, we have seen that. Okay? Now, Guna Bhedat. Tatvik, Rajasik, Tamasik. You see, the best example of, in Ramayana, we find this Ravan, Kumbhakarna, Vibhishan, all the three of them did tapas or not. So without bhakti, you cannot do any tapas. So bhakti was there. But what did they ask? You know that Ravana wanted that he should never die. He should rule over the whole world, including the other world also. And all pleasure, powers, everything that. So anyone whose bhakti is because of this, then it's called Rajasik. Kumbhakarna, as the description is there, whatever reason, suddenly he has to sleep. Or some Rakshasas were very peculiar. Their bhakti was very strange. That Bhasmasur, Lord Shiva was pleased. I said, what do you want? whomever I touch on the head of person, that she should die. We should be reduced to ashes. Wow, wow, wow. What kind of this is? Bhakti for this purpose. And our Ashutosh Bhagavan said, okay. And his Bhasmasura said, I experiment on you only. This story, Bhagavan Shivaji, he knew that he's, when the vara is given, it's effective. So he ran it instead. Now there are different versions are there. Was that one? Mohini came. Oh, Bhagavan Vishnu came, Mohini came. Hey, what happened? Somewhere says, other somebody came, all right, but confused him completely. So he said to Mohini, I want you. He said, you have to dance with me, and whatever I do, you have to do the same thing. Yeah. So she was dancing, he was dancing, and different pose, this, that, and one pose she kept, ting, her hand on her own head, and he was so completely enamored, and it reduced to ashes. What kind of it? Tamasi? Vibhishan, he asked for Hari Bhakti. So sattvic nature, because of gunas, somebody has sattvic disposition, that person will ask something, rajasic will ask something, right? Now, arthadi bhedat, artha jidnyasu artharthi. So now in the sattvic, rajasic, tamasic, naturally sattvic bhakti will be shrestha. Sattvic, rajasic, tamasic. So in that sattvic bhakti will be shrestha. Now artha jidnyasu artharthi. Now what is this artha jidnyasu artharthi? How? Now see the next sutra, which is said there.
उत्तरस्मात्
पूर्व पूर्वा श्रेयाय भवति I say as compared with the उत्तर भक्ति the पूर्व भक्ति is श्रेष्ठ that means what सात्विक राजसिक तामसिक so last what is said तामसिक उत्तर है उत्तर में the letter Purva means former, earlier one. So as compared with tamasic, rajasic is little better. As compared to rajasic, then sattvic is the best. Purva purva, seya bhavati. Now here, artha jidnyasu arthati. How do you say count? It's interesting. Artha jidnyasu artharthi. It is interesting to note, see, how you define this artha jidnyasu artharthi. Suppose, we say artha means the one who remembers God only when he is in difficulty and distress. He is one. The artharthi is, even when there is prosperity but he wants more, So he is remembering God even in prosperity also. And Jidnyasu is the one who wants to, Tattva Jidnyasu wants to know God. Now if you say these three, then in that case what will happen, do you know? Tattva Jidnyasu will be the best. Artharthi, second number pe aaya. And artha, the one who remembers only in difficulties. But if you define these words differently, artha means not only in distress because of worldly kind of sorrow, but like Mirabai, like Gopika, They were sorrow not because of not worldly gain. When everything is there from worldly standpoint, all prosperity is there, comfort is there, this is there, but तड़पता रहता है अखियां हरि दर्शन की प्यासी. देन आर्त भगवान, आर्त भक्त इज द बेस्ट, ही द बेस्ट. जिज्ञासु विल कम सेकंड, अर्थार्थी विल बी लास्ट. देन हाउ यू डिफाइन? जनरली व्हाट यू हैव सीन फ्रॉम द वर्ल्डली स्टैंड पॉइंट, When somebody is in sorrow, जाए दुख में सुमिरन सब करे, सुख में करे न कोई, जो सुख में सुमिरन करे तो दुख का है को हो. Generally people remember God in दुखम, but if they can remember in सुखम also, then दुख will never be there. So how you put artha artharthi jidnyasu? Artha jidnyasu artha, artho jidnyasu artharthi. So artha will be the best. Jidnyasu will be second, artharthi will be the first. Because one is just wanting more and more of this, more and more of that. उत्तरस्मात् उत्तरस्मात् पूर्व पूर्व श्रेया भवती. आइडिया इज इन द सात्विक राजसिक तामसिक, सात्विक भक्ति इज द बेस्ट, बट स्टिल इट इज स्टिल नॉट बिकम गुणातीत. गुणरहितम नहीं हुआ है, अभी तो गुण में ही है. अरे रजोगुण इज देयर. So, artha, clear? Artha, jidnyasu, artha. But all of them are bhaktas. And Bhagwan says, they all are my bhaktas. He says, my bhaktas, chaturvidha bhajante mam. I always remember, one person asked me, why Bhagwan says they are his bhaktas? Because they are not worshipping him, loving him for his sake. Somebody wants to get rid of sorrow, somebody wants to get more prosperity. So their interest is different only. I only gave the answer. Are, if Bhagwan accepts them as his devotees, why you should have any problem? Why do you say how they can, we can call them bhaktas? Bhagwan says they are my bhaktas. Tu zabardasti kehta hai wo bhakta nahi hai. अरे the very fact they worship Bhagwan for whatever reason, that means what? They accept his existence. They accept that Bhagwan is omnipotent. They accept that Bhagwan can fulfill their desire. So for whatever reason, at least they have approached God instead of other human being. Therefore they are bhaktas only. And in the beginning, they might approach for this and that, but later on, it will, they will go to him only for his sake. All these examples are there in our itihas, puranas. In the beginning, they ask for something, but later on, they say, no, no, this is, we don't want it. Huh? Even the Tulsi Rama say, Vibhishan says, Bhagwan, earlier I had some kind of vasana, but now, so you flooded my heart with your soul love. Now everything is gone away. Now I don't want anything. Possible? This is bhakti. Okay. Shri Krishna Govinda Hare Murare. Shri Krishna Govinda Hare Nath Nath Shri Krishna Govinda Hare Murare. कृष्णचंद्र भगवान की जय। श्री सद्गुरुनाथ महाराज की जय। ओम पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ओम शांति शांति शांति। हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। हरि ओम।